Hi, this is Tom with Horizon Hobby and Spektrumrc. Today we are going to go over how to update, well, register, and update your Spektrum radio, like the DX6E. First things you need are a radio or a SD card or memory card. Both of these ones work great. I've got one that's a 2 gigabyte. I think that's about as small as you can get them nowadays. I believe you can take up to a 32. That's what I'm using here. Has no problem reading either of these cards. So let's see, put it into the bottom slot on a DX6E or a 6 up to an 8. They're all in the bottom like that. Just kind of pick away. It's just like trying to plug in a USB cable. You always almost plug it in wrong every time. So just kind of find the way it pops in. On. You want to go to the system setup menu, which is there. We select yes. It says it asks you if you want to turn off the RF essentially, because when you go into this menu, this light here will turn off, meaning the RF is turned off. We scroll down to system settings, and then we've got the word next over here. That means go to the next page. This is what we're going to do. Next. Next again. And now we've got our serial number. It's about 28 digits long. It's pretty long. So the reason we got an SD card in there is because we can use the export function. What that does is it just saves the serial number as a file called MyDX6E, or if you're using a DX9, it'll be MyDX9. And that file is now on your SD card. So we'll just click back because it's on there now. So when we put that SD card into our computer or our laptop, it will give us that file. So let's do that. So you might be asking yourself, why do I need to register and update my products? Well, registration for one does a few things. You'll get email updates about new products, about your products, if you've registered a product. Those updates might include, hey, look at this new feature that's available. If there's a bulletin about your product, we want to tell you about. And on top of that, if there's contests or special offers or giveaways that we have, you'll get emails about that. So like, let's say if you registered your radio today, a DX6E, once there's an update available for it, you'll get an email saying, hey, version yada yada is now available. Click here to update. And it'll take you to the website and we'll do exactly what we're doing now. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is go to SpektrumRC.com, and we will click on sign up if you're new, or log in if you've made a login before. We're going to sign up and make a login. We're going to call ourselves Jim Leahy, TBB number one. After you're done filling out the form, you need to go down here and enter in this CAPTCHA code. This is a code that essentially proves that you're not a robot. If you're a robot, you wouldn't be able to read this image. Register. Okay, once we've clicked registered, it'll say a confirmation email has been sent to your email address. You always want to make sure that after you've made your new account, you go to your email and there's going to be a link there. So let's go to our email. In. There it is. That's our email. We're going to click on this blue link. Thank you. Awesome. Let's log in with our new account. Okay, so here's where you register our DX6E. I'm going to click create or register new product, go down, select model out of the drop down list, and this is where we put in our serial number. Now if we wanted to read it off the radio, we could do that here. It's a long number, That's why we're using our SD card to make it easy. So we're going to click on select here where it says upload serial number from XML file. You'll remember that from the last scene we had the mydx6e.xml file. There it is on the SD card. Open, and then when we click upload from XML file, it'll put it there for us, that whole number. Now, the rest of this form you don't really need to fill out. You can if you want. We're going to call this Jim's DX6E. We'll say we bought it at the local hobby shop and we bought it. All right, another CAPTCHA code. All right, there it is. So if there were any updates for the DX6E, we would click on download updates and would see an update here. But there isn't, because the DX6E at this point in time is pretty much as advanced as you got on the firmware. It's got all the bells and whistles, no need for an update for it. Works great out of the box. All right, but we will register a DX9 so you can see how the update process works. And it does the same thing. It's the same for the 6E. So we're going to go to My Products. We're going to click Register New Product. We're going to swap it out for my DX9's SD card. Just in. Computer makes a little beep. Yeah, we know it's there. Right, Donald's DX9. I'll just show you how quick and easy it can be. Got all my lists on my DX9 SD card. Click open, upload. We don't, like I said, we don't need to fill out this stuff. This time I'm not gonna. CAPTCHA 3C84D3. Register. Alright, got the DX9. We're gonna click download updates. And we're gonna have the most recent firmware, version 1.10a, download. Usually it'll go blank screen, but something will download. If it's Firefox, it'll say download up here, a little arrow here. I think Internet Explorer and Chrome are down here. I like to click here and just click show in folder. All right, we're going to send to movable disk, that's the SD card. So now it's going to be saved on here. Yep, there it is, the spmtx.sax file. We want to keep it that name. It makes it easy for the radio to recognize it and update it. So let's do that. Okay, so we've got the firmware update on our DX9's SD card. I'm going to grab my DX9. Find the SD card slot on it right there. Figure out which way it goes in. Yeah, I got it right the first time. And then, if we leave that file as spmtx.sax, and when we turn on the radio, we will get this loading bar. It's going to go across the screen several times. If you turn it on and it doesn't load, try another SD card, try a new file. You'll know immediately that it's not working if you don't see this bar. Date. We can test that it's up to date by going to the system setup menu, clicking on yes, going to where our serial number was. So next page, next page, and it says our version number right at the bottom, 1.10A or 0A. And that's about it. We're good to go. So if you ever need help, reference this video to update your DX9 or DX6E once there's an update for it. There's the same process works for all these radios. All right, thanks. Hopefully that helped.